done. What is up, y'all, and welcome to another video. If it's your first time stopping by my channel, I'm Jeffro, and this is Jeffro's Fishkeeping. Today I'm working in the fish room, finishing up a rack that I started a couple of weeks ago to put the Cheese Creek L393s in, and that's what I'm doing today, and I'm gonna take you guys along with. Hopefully you guys enjoy. What is up, y'all? I have tried everything, and I think instead of being lazy, I'm gonna go ahead and just quit this stuff and paint the tanks. I would rather get them breeding better than to be able to film them. And right now, this is a pain in the butt to get this sheet up. It does make the tanks pretty dark. But two things I gotta do. I gotta go get some paint and paint these tanks. And then I've also gotta get my lids figured out. I have not made it to the glass shop yet. I do have some polycarbonate in the basement, enough to do one tank, so I'm gonna work on getting this one tank done today to where I can put my L393 Cheese Creek plecos in here. All right, guys, I stayed up late last night and painted the sides of these 20 longs, painted them a matte black. I used this, acrylic paint, just your black matte, or matte black acrylic, and I rolled it on with the sponge roller, painted the backs and the sides. And what I'm gonna do on the bottoms, since I've got so much stuff in these tanks, is on the bottoms, I'm gonna put like either a black trash bag underneath the tank, or like maybe one of those black tablecloths or something. In order to do that, I have to drain the tank completely, but right now that's how dark they are with no lights on during the day and the bottoms not being painted. Wanting to get a little darker than that, but that is still dark. It's a lot darker than what it was, and what I'm trying to do here is mimic the wild as much as possible. Putting these guys in a smaller tank to make for sure that they are only thinking about breeding and eating instead of goofing around and staying apart from each other. And just trying to mimic the wild as much as possible in a smaller system and keep it dark like they're on the bottom in a little cave or something, you know, or under a log or something like that. And so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna drain all these tanks down and put the covering underneath them that's gonna make the tank the rest of the way dark. Then I am going to put water back in it and for sure get the Cheese Creeks in this tank right here before the end of the video. I will need to show you them before I put them in, because even with the lights on, I've only got one view, and that is from the end of the tank, you know. So it's gonna be what it is what it is, you know what I mean? What is up, guys? Thought I would check back in and let you see the progress. I've got that, I use tablecloth, black vinyl tablecloth, 97 cents for a big tablecloth. Ended up doing pretty good, actually. Just had to fold it up and tuck it under. I would recommend painting the bottom of the tanks, but I didn't. And, couldn't get the tanks dark enough. So now they will be a lot darker. You can see some places where I need to go back over with the paint in the back. These little bad boys are gonna be a lot darker. So next thing is, on this top tank here, I'm gonna put 20 gallons of the tank water that the L393s are in right now, and the rest tap water, conditioned tap water, and wait for the temp to come back up once I get the tanks filled and heated back up, and then I will check back in with you guys and put some plecos in here. I'm excited. All right, guys, pretty much ready to rock. Got the lights on right now, and like I said in the last video when I built this stand, the only reason why I have lights on there is for video purposes. These lights are gonna be shut off all the time. I've got them all on a dedicated switch, and they will only be on whenever I'm filming, or let's say I'm trying to do something in the tank and I need more light than just a flashlight. But 99.9% of the time, they're gonna be off. I don't know if I talked about it in my last video, but I did, to help this tank cycle, I did add a sponge filter back there, and I will go ahead and add sponge filters to those in the upcoming videos that I've got going for those two tanks down there. Just to have a little safeguard. With this new Ziz filter, they're working properly and they're working good. I know that they're really good for ammonia, to keep ammonia down, so they're gonna be really good for plecos, but I think I am, just to be on the safe side, gonna run sponge filters as well. I am running them off of a central air system, so I can turn the flow down. I've heard plecos like to have high flow. I've heard plecos like to have low flow. This is a project. I can't just put them in the tank and get them to breed right when I put them in the tank. Otherwise, we would all be rich. So there's gonna be a lot of tweaking and playing around with this setup, but I'm done for now. I'm gonna wait till the temperature comes up on the water, and I'll be grabbing those plecos and putting them in the tank. So the next time you see me, in the snap of a finger, we're gonna have some L393s trying to get them caught. All right, guys, one more thing I forgot to talk about is, one more thing I forgot that I gotta get done is, I gotta get a lid cut for this top tank while I'm waiting for the temperature to come up. So I'm getting ready to do that right now. But another thing that I wanted to talk about is, a few weeks back on Amazon, I picked up one of these knife magnet systems. And basically all it is it's got a plate behind it that's got a heavy duty magnet on it with two holes, and you drill it into a piece of wood, which it works out perfect with my stand here. And then this slip cover goes over the top of it, and you can magnet your aquascaping tools on it, and it works slick as snot. I mean, you just set them up against it and it magnetizes to it. So I'm really, really digging that. I always know where my tweezers and my scissors and my knife and my algae scraper, I know where it's all at, and I don't have to worry about finding it. It's all there. I really love it. They're really cheap on Amazon, and I think I'm gonna get some more. So off to the basement to cut the top, and I'll check back in once I get it put on and fitted and all of that jazz. All right, guys, I got my lid cut, and you know what? I think that's what I'm gonna stick with. I really like that stuff. The polycarbonate, you get it in a big, long 8-foot sheet. You get it shipped right to your house. It's really easy to cut down, and yeah. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and order another sheet to come in time for me to do the videos for these and just be done with it. Stuff's easy to work with, it's nice. It also lets light through if you want light to come through. So yeah, I'm pretty much done with this tank. All I gotta do is wait for the water to warm up, get these plecos up in here. Can't wait. All right, guys, it is time for me to catch the Cheese Creek and Sistrus. So I'm gonna go ahead and use a net and a Kool-Aid pitcher. I'm gonna use the net to wrangle them, and I'm gonna use the Kool-Aid pitcher to actually get them out. So I'm gonna put you on a little better of a view to show you the whole tank, and we will go from there. All right, guys. Here goes nothing. I'm gonna go ahead and get this driftwood out of here. Now there are hundreds of plecos in here, so I have to be careful not to grab any of them. See the male, he went ahead and shot off. The male, or the female, is still down here. This driftwood is very, very heavy. It's waterlogged. I'm gonna have to use both hands, but both the male and the female are both off. I'll put this down in a bucket. That way, if we have any tag-alongs, we can deal with it. Probably gonna do these guys one at a time, whichever one is the easiest to catch. Female is acting like a freak. Whoa, she's acting like a real freak. The only thing I don't like about this is there are two albinos in there with her. So I'm gonna have to go get a shrimp net or something to get them out. But she is in there. And hopefully she doesn't tip over. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna hang this on the edge here, and we will be back. All right, guys, we got the female right there. Finally got her out. I had two baby albinos in the same Kool-Aid pitcher. It was a pain in the butt. But the male is back here behind this sponge filter right over here, right there. I'm gonna go ahead and try to grab him next. He is in, and there's an endler in there. There is an endler. At least it's an endler. Endlers are a lot easier to catch than baby plecos. He's acting like a fruitcake right now, so I gotta hurry up. There we go. All right. So, got the endler out. We're gonna go ahead and get the male in there. He did plop pretty hard, hopefully. Didn't mess him up too much. Ay, ay, ay. Try to get them into their tank as soon as possible here. I do want to maybe get the light over here and take a look at them with you guys. You guys have not seen them ever since I first unboxed them. Light hooked on for it won't come off. When I first brought them home, you guys didn't get to see their true coloring, but there's the male. Look at how nice he is. Very, very nice pleco. He is spazzing out right now. Female is nice too. Probably go ahead and get them moved where they don't freak out too much. So let's go ahead and cut to that right now. Man, isn't he nice? Look at him. Very nice pleco. All right, guys. Gonna go ahead and put these guys in their forever home. Just gotta move the lid. I don't know how much of this you're gonna be able to see. And then once they're in the tank, might not be able to see them at all, but I did not want to stress these guys out any. So go ahead and put the mail in first. Bada bing, bada bang. Put the female in next. Good luck, guys. Good luck. Lid back on here. And we will check them out. They're checking things out, definitely. Acting like a male and a female does. He's pushing her around. Since they've been in the low boy in there, they have done a lot of chilling out under the driftwood. She spends 90% of her time under the driftwood, and at night she comes out to eat. The male, he has been coming out during the daytime to eat. A little bit more active. They may go back to just being nocturnal. I think I'm gonna turn them into nocturnal in this tank though, because it's gonna be dark in here. I wish that I had a view of both ends of the cave. Once they start caving up, they'll probably choose the other side of the cave because it will be the darkest. So this is pretty much it, guys. Pretty simple little setup. I don't know why my focus just went off there, but pretty simple little setup. I've got one of those Sergeant Tank Pleco caves that the top comes off of. I've got a big chunk of Malaysian driftwood in here. I've got some Indian almond leaves in here. I've got a heater in there. Got the temperature set about 76, 78 degrees. 78 is where it's been kind of hanging out at. 20 gallon long, bare bottom. I've got it completely blacked out with a Zis fluid media filter and a sponge filter. Got a polycarbonate lid with a cheap Aquanet light that is only gonna be used for filming purposes only. And yeah. Now all we can do is just wait and see. But they're just kind of chilling right now. The male's kind of breathing heavy back there, but I think we are going to have some success, but we will just have to wait and see. Glad to have the move over. It did seem to be pretty stressful. They both wanted to go into the net. I was wanting to use the net as a guide. So need to probably come up with something a little better than that, like something kind of like the premises of a stiff fly swatter to kind of guide them in to where they want to go into the pitcher instead of the net, because I didn't want them to get caught up in the net. So anyhow, looks like they're doing good. Who knows, I may check back in before the end of the video, but I may not. So if I don't, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and wish me luck on getting these guys to breed. So what'd you guys think? Sorry about the part where I got them in the specimen containers and I didn't get to show you guys for very long. What I did show you though, sure did show you what they really look like. They've been in this low boy for over a month now, and they really have colored up, and they are amazing. I was just afraid of stressing them out too much on the move. They were kind of spazzing a little bit there, and I wanted to hurry up and get them moved before I stressed them out. So I apologize for that, but what I did show to you guys, wow, they are a beautiful pleco, and I cannot wait to see if I can get these guys breeding. Thanks for coming along on today's video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed, and we'll catch you all on the next one. Peace out, y'all. We'll be right back.